less enthusiasm.
Why? We have to review a game called Pack and Roll.
Look, we love Pac-Man, we love the Nintendo DS, but when you put these things together, as in pack picks, the result is horrible.
Sadly, Pac-Man is once again hitting the DS, and once again, the title is totally stupid.
Here's our review of Pack and Roll.
Yeah.
25 years ago, something happened. Something wonderful. And now, because there's money to be made, Pac-Man takes his laissez-faire attitude all the way to the DS. It's time to pack and roll.
Pack and roll!
But enough about Willie Nelson. This is Pac-Man's time. This is his DS game. If you haven't seen Pac-Man since his first divorce and rehabilitation, the game remains the same. Gobble up little pellets, pack and roll your way through mazes and obstacles, and take on groovy ghoulies before they take you out. Just know that those ghosts Pac-Man has hounded for years are PO'd at him. They hate his success. They hate his happiness. They play a hate. So they call in the big guns. His name, Golvis, a rock and rollin' friend of ghosts everywhere. He's got a little bit of pack and roll hoochie-coo in his background, if you know what I mean. I know this ghost does.
Pack and roll!
If it's been a long time since you packed and rolled, get acquainted with the DS stylus. With the stylus, you can roll if you want to. Roll around the Pac-Man world. Like Ron Howard, Pac-Man wears many hats. But unlike Opie, he's not hiding his baldness. He lets it all hang out. Like this suit of armor skull cap that helps Packy get to those hard-to-reach pellets. And this green hat, now with wings. It helps Packy speed up and is a stylish part of any wardrobe. Now let's meet the screens. The top screen is a Gemini, loves walks on the beach and showing off mazes and obstacles to Pac-Man lovers everywhere. The bottom screen, a non-smoker, is proud of presenting a roly-poly Pac-Man, a Pac-Man that packs and rolls all night and parties every day. I think this ghost knows what I'm saying.
Pack and roll!
Pack and roll takes Pac-Man through such similar levels as Sweet Land, UFO Land, and Gyro Jungle, or as it's called in America's psyche, Vietnam. After a while, well, more like 10 minutes, all the levels kind of blend into each other. It could drive you mad. Even more maddening, you'll get through this game in no time. I mean, no time. A couple of hours, that's it. Not much of a party. But you can unlock the classic Pac-Man game. That's a novel concept. For the fact it seems a bit too intentionally gimmicky. For the fact that pack and roll should have been a little part of a bigger game instead of an entire game in itself. For the fact that it just wasn't compelling enough to buy. We give pack and roll 2 Run It at Game Flies out of 5.
Pack and roll!
And you know, if you're not like a really big Pac-Man fan, you should probably just avoid it altogether.
Avoid it the way that I avoid maturity and responsibility.
Avoid it the way I avoid taxes.
Avoid it the way Michael Bay avoids making good films.
That is avoidance.
Oh, yeah.